Welcome to Ray Academy and welcome to my new live class. And friends, in this class we are going to cover weekly current affairs week 4 for September month 2021. Lithium and its distribution across the globe. So we should understand why this topic is in use. Why we are going to discuss this topic. Okay, please keep in the mind. Okay. So now let's start our discussion. So first of all, friends, let's understand the context. Argentina, the fourth largest producer of lithium metal, is now speeding up the process of mineral exploitation. So please keep in the mind, Argentina has the Argentina is the fourth largest producer of lithium metal. Okay. Until now, the extraction was done sluggishly due to the high tax rate, red tape, and rampant inflation. And also, friend, we should understand what is the background. And friend, the growing demand for white gold is climbing new height every year due to it being the ultralight battery metal. And friends, we have discussed in any class related to lithium or also related to electrical vehicle. So we can say now that electrical vehicle demand is increasing. That means that lithium demand is also increasing side by side. And friends, the other reason for the spike has been the global rush towards environmentally friendly modes of transport. That means the electrical vehicle. Please keep in the mind. That means electrical vehicle. So we can easily say that the lithium demand is increasing in the globe, increasing in the world. Okay. And friends, among the top lithium producing countries, Argentina comes fourth in the list. So first of all, you'll have to keep in the mind that Argentina, fourth. That means that Argentina has the Argentina is the fourth largest producer of lithium. And friends, this could make Argentina an important player in the electrical vehicle supply chain. So that means that you can say electrical vehicle news. Environmental friendly modes of transport is in frequent news. So there is a chance that you will get a question related to electrical vehicle, and also you can say you will get a question related to environmentally friendly modes of transport. So we can say in electrical vehicle, lithium is the core part. Lithium is, you can say, one of the most important part. So why there is increasing demand for lithium metal? We should understand why there is demand. Okay. So first of all, friends, you can see here the increased applicability. That means the usage of lithium, usage of lithium is increasing day by day. And in order to take advantage of renewable energy, the need for bulk energy storage application has been increasing. And this includes electrical vehicles and backup electrical storage system. Electric storage system. So please keep in the mind, this is very, very important. That means lithium usage is increasing. That means increased applicability. Okay. Then second point is good life. You can see here. Second point is about good life. Okay. So lithium ion based batteries have a good rate of charging and they last longer. That means the battery made for lithium, there will be a very good, and also we can say the lithium ion based batteries have a good rate of charging and they last longer. And the third is high energy density. And in addition to this, the energy density of the lithium ion battery is higher. And then friends, there's wide usage of lithium. So please keep in the mind. And being primarily used in battery, it also finds it used in glass, ceramics, rocket fuel, and lasers. Okay, so basically four points you'll have to keep in the mind related to demands of lithium metal. Why? So first, increased applicability. Second, there's good life. Third, high energy density. And fourth, wide usage. Can you add more points? Can you add more points? Why? Okay, the demand of lithium is increasing. Can you add more points? Anyone? Try to participate. Can you add more one or two points?
Sir, environment friendly.
One by one. First of all, please raise your hand, and after that, I will go through one by one. Yeah, Shobhan, go ahead.
The world try to shift renewable energy like solar energy and electrical energy. Try to shift from oil energy to renewable energy, so lithium demand increase day by day.
Okay, very good. Yeah, anyone?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Lithium is required for mobile battery also.
Yes, very good. Yeah, mobile battery, yeah. Anyone else? Can you add one or two points? We have discussed four points. Okay, these four points you can say is the core point and most important point. You can also add your point, and please try to add, okay, more points. Please try to participate. If you'll participate, that means your concept will be clear. Okay, so now let's discuss the next you can say key part of this topic. So we have discussed key why there is demand for lithium metal. So do you know about the facts related to lithium? So now I'm going to tell you about the facts related to lithium. First of all, friends, you can see here, he has Afghanistan, okay, mineral riches, okay. And friends, Afghanistan may have the world's largest lithium reserves, states a US agency report, according to US agency report. You can see here, here's the usage of lithium, okay, usage of lithium in, you can say, various portion, various sector. So you can see here, first of all, there's 65%, okay, uses in battery for laptop, mobiles, electrical vehicles, then 18% in ceramic and glass, okay, ceramics and glass making, then 5% in lubricating greases, okay, then 3% in polymer production, okay, 3% in polymer production, please keep in the mind. And friends, then other is 9%, so you will have to keep in the mind. Now friends, let's discuss the lithium reserve across the world. Okay, by this chart you can easily understand. So if you can say, according to US agency report, is 18 million ton of lithium. So you can see here, Bolivia 21%, Argentina 17%, Chile 9%, then you can see America, United States of America, 6.8%, Australia, 6.3%, China, 4.5%, and others, 15%. Okay, so please keep in the mind, this is very, very important fact. You can add these, facts in your answer writing, in your mains answer. So, and also, if you'll get, appear in UPSC, you can add this point in your essay also, because if you'll get a topic related to renewable energy, you can add this, facts, you can add these points in your answer writing, in your essay. So please keep in the mind. So we have discussed related to usage of, you can say, lithium. Now let's discuss the facts related to lithium. What is lithium? Okay, so friends, first of all, now I'm going to tell you, please keep in the mind, lithium is a metal of utmost importance, and it is everywhere today. And lithium is a soft silver metal. Silvery metal. Okay, lithium is a soft silvery metal, and it has the lowest density of all metals. Okay, lithium has the lowest density of all metals. Friends, first of all, sorry, my pen tab is not working, so I am not able to write. Okay, So please keep in the mind, I am telling you the most important facts. And if you have blank page open, you can write, and also you can make your own notes in your own language. So I told you that lithium is a metal of utmost importance, and it is everywhere today. And lithium is a silvery metal, and lithium has the lowest density of all metals. And friends, also we can say it reacts vigorously with water. And lithium does not occur as the metal in nature. Please keep in the mind, UPSC and State Public Service Commission can play a game with you that lithium occur as the metal in nature. No, lithium does not occur as the metal in nature, but is found combined in a small amounts in nearly all igneous rocks and in the waters of many mineral springs and friends, do you know about the igneous rock, anyone? What is igneous rock?
Yes sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Igneous rock lava ko jo solidified hota hai na, wahi hota hai.
Okay. Yes sir.
Yes sir, main bhi wahi bolne wala.
Okay. There is three types of rocks: igneous rock, then
sedimentary, metamorphic.
Metamorphic rock. So first of all, you know, on the earth, so igneous rock will be made first, after that sedimentary rock, after that metamorphic rock. So in sedimentary, in igneous rock, there is no, you can say ki, you will not get examples related to biotic activities in igneous rock, because temperature of igneous rock is too high. So please keep in the mind. So I told you about the igneous rock also. So please keep in the mind, and please try to cover types of rocks also. And friends, I told you about the lithium does not occur as the metal in nature. And you will have to keep in the mind, friends, that lithium is currently producing chili from brines that yield lithium carbonate when treated with sodium carbonate. And the lithium is produced by the electrolysis of molten lithium chloride and potassium chloride So basically, according to me, you will have to keep in the mind one important point, that the lithium does not occur as the metal in nature. And lithium is a metal, and usage of lithium is increasing day by day, And friends, there's also one concept is important related to lithium. There's lithium triangle, lithium triangle is Latin America. So now I am going to tell you about the lithium triangle. You can see here lithium triangle in Latin America, lithium triangle in Latin America. That means the lithium reserves have been found in all the continents but Chile. Please write down, you'll have to keep in the mind, but Chile and Argentina and Bolivia together are referred to as the lithium triangle. That means he holding underneath in its salt flats more than 75% of world supply. Please keep in the mind. That means more than 70% of world supply. 75% from three countries. Which one? Chile. Please keep in the mind. Then there is friends Bolivia and Argentina. So here's Chile. You can see here's Bolivia. And here's Argentina. And we have discussed that Argentina is the fourth largest producing country in lithium. So you can see here, there's also a desert, Atacama Desert in Chile. Please keep in the mind. And these three countries are the part of lithium triangle in Latin America, and also you can say in South America continent. Please keep in the mind, this is very, very important. So there's also one thing you should know about, in natural salt, pans or salt flats are the large flat area of ground covered with salt and other minerals, and they are usually found in deserts. That means the Salar de Uyuni in Bolivia is the largest salt flat in the world. Salar, S-A-L-A-R, Salar, and D-E-D देन UYUNI, ओके, इन बोलिविया इज द लार्जेस्ट सॉल्ट फ्लैट इन द वर्ल्ड एंड दे आर नॉट लाइक सॉल्ट एवेपोरेशन पॉन्ड्स. बेसिकली यू कैन से कि इट इज आर्टिफिशियल, ओके, एंड विंड एंड वाटर वर्क इन टैंडम टू क्रिएट अ फ्लैट सर्फेस ऑफ सॉल्ट. ओके, प्लीज प्लीज कीप इन द माइंड. एंड फ्रेंड आई टोल्ड यू कि लिथियम आयरन, सॉरी लिथियम ट्राइंगल, सो बेसिकली थ्री कंट्री आर द पार्ट ऑफ लिथियम. ओके, प्लीज प्लीज कीप इन द माइंड. ओके, आई टोल्ड यू, सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड फ्रेंड्स नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस कि द लिथियम ट्राइंगल बींग अ पार्ट ऑफ द ड्राई लैंडस्केप मेक्स द एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ लिथियम अ कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रोसेस. एंड एज द माइनर्स हैव टू ड्रिल होल्स इन सॉल्ट फ्लैट इन ऑर्डर टू पंप मिनरल रिच brine to the surface, and the mineral rich brine is then made to evaporate for months, resulting in the residue of manganese, borax, and lithium salts. And these salts are then filtered again and left to evaporate once more. And it takes 12 to 18 months for the filtration process to complete, and then lithium carbon, okay, carbonate. Can be extracted. Okay, lithium carbonate can be extracted. So this is the process. Okay, of you can say keep making the lithium. And friends, there's also a story related to Argentina. Kid, what is the you can say contribution of Argentina in lithium? So friends, in ancestral land of Atacama. Okay, please keep in the mind. In the okay, you can see in the ancestral land of Atacama. Like the stockpiles of white gold. White gold means silvery white, okay, alkali metal, that means ki lithium. And you can say ki lithium is worth of billions of dollars. That means the importance of lithium is too high. Demand of lithium is too high. Okay. And friends, since 2018, the economy of Argentina is in crisis. And it was the time when it approached to International Monetary Fund for a $57 billion loan. Okay, and Argentina faced many economic challenges, including rapid depreciation of the currency, economic contraction, and a high rate of inflation. High rate of inflation. Do you know, friends? The IMF provides these two. Okay, International Monetary Organization. You will have to keep in the mind. One is IMF, okay, International Monetary Fund, and second is World Bank, and both okay provides loan, but there is difference between the IMF loans and the World Bank loan. Can you tell me what is the difference between IMF loan and what is the you can say key difference between IMF loan and World Bank loan? Anyone? You should know. Yes, Shobhan, go ahead.
Sir, IMF give loan at last time when the country is about to crash, and World Bank is giving loan when the country is approaching to World Bank.
Okay. Anyone?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
वो interest rate का हो सकता है कुछ.
Okay.
IMF also giving sanction to the country for giving loan.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Yeah.
Sir, actually, when the government, state government or union government is approaching IMF, any country, they are generally giving loans to government. And it is for any short term, maybe some duration 5 years or 10 years like that.
Okay.
But when the World Bank is giving loan, it is for long term, many 20 years or 15 years projects, and the interest rates are very less compared to IMF.
Okay.
And World Bank is giving loan for any project, developmental project, any specific projects.
Okay. Okay. Very good. Yeah,
and both are twin sisters of Bretton's. Yeah, this one.
Bretton Woods. Yes,
yeah, Bretton Woods. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Tejas Mita.
Sir, World Bank gives loan for developmental work, and for other like to meet other expenses of the country if it is required. But IMF gives loans as per the SDR.
Okay.
So as per that only IMF gives loan.
Okay, very good. So basically, I will tell you in a one line. Okay, you'll have to keep in the mind that IMF provides loan. Okay, in the crisis of balance of payment. That means that IMF provides loans with terms and condition. If any country, okay, will follow the terms of condition of IMF, after that IMF, okay, provides loans and basically provides loans for balance of payment crisis. For example, in 1991 in India, India approached to IMF. And IMF, okay, put three terms and conditions. That means India should follow LPG, liberalization, privatization, and globalization. So basically, IMF provides for the loan, okay, related to strengthening of economy and also the balance payment of crisis. And second thing, World Bank provides loans for, you can say, eradication of poverty. Basically, the objective of World Bank is eradication of poverty. And also provides loans for, you can say, infrastructure development. And the interest rate, okay, there is a difference between the interest rate also. First of all, you should know about the term. IMF provides, okay, loans, you can say, 5 to 10 years. But World Bank, okay, will provide loan, okay, basically for long term period, 30 years, 20 years, 15 years, okay. So please keep in the mind. These two difference, okay, is the, you can say, main difference between IMF and World Bank, okay. And Niha Ranjan has told that if IMF and the World Bank is the twin sister of Bretton Woods, okay, conference. So please keep in the mind. So basically, friends, we have discussed related to Argentina so far, okay. So Argentina has an excellent source of lithium, and it has the potential to compensate for the macroeconomic instability of the country. How Argentina, okay, will produce lithium, and Argentina, okay, will sell in the world, and after that they will use, you can say, now they will get the dollar, and after that Argentina, okay, will stable the economic, you can say, stable the Argentina economy, Argentina government, okay, will stable the economic government. And friends, there is also one thing is very, very important. There is India's stake involved in Argentina. What is the India's stake involved in Argentina? Let's understand. So first of all, friends, there is Kabil. Okay, Kabil means Khanij Videsh India Limited. Please keep in the mind, for the UPSC prelims, this is very, very important. Okay, so Kabil has inked a pact with an Argentina firm to jointly look for the possibilities of finding lithium in a South American country. Okay, so friends, for, you can say, prelims, you'll have to read the location, okay, and the boundaries of Argentina. Boundaries of Argentina, because you can say you may get a question related to mapping. Okay, so please keep in the mind. And I told you Kabil, that means Khanij Videsh India Limited, has inked a pact with an Argentina firm to jointly look for the possibilities of finding lithium in a South American country. So what is Kabil, friends? Kabil is a joint venture. Okay, what is Kabil? Kabil is a joint venture, and it was set up in 2019, and by three state-owned company. First, National Aluminium Company Limited, NALCO. Second, HCL, that means Hindustan Copper Limited. And third, Mineral Exploration Corporation Limited, in equity participation of 40:30:30. Okay, and you can say Kabil mandate is to acquire strategic mineral asset like lithium and cobalt abroad. And Kabil is also exploring the other two countries of lithium triangle, namely Bolivia and Chile. And in a lithium triangle, I told you Argentina, Bolivia and Chile. Argentina, Bolivia and Chile. Okay, this is very, very important. Okay, this is very, very important. And friends, Kabil, okay, potentially decrease our dependency on China as the key source of both raw material and sales. Now, friends, we have discussed, you can say, facts related to Argentina. We have discussed facts related to world. Now, let's discuss the lithium reserve in India. Anyone, do you have any, you can say, information related to lithium reserve in India? Anyone? Try to guess, okay? Don't hesitate. If you will...
Sir, in Deccan Plateau, like, under Telangana, Maharashtra, and there is lithium reserve in India, sir.
Okay.
I don't clear, sir.
No problem, no problem. Very good. You have participated now also. You, okay, want to reply. This is very good, okay? And please use to. And also, anyone? Nihar?
I think it's northeast. It has been found.
Okay, in northeast. Okay. Jitnaik.
I think it is desert, sir. Third desert.
Okay, third desert. Okay. Anyone?
Sir, in Jadugoda Mines.
Okay. Yeah, in Jadugoda Mines. Okay. Anyone else? Oh, very good. You have participated. Very good. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you the lithium reserve in India. Okay, this is very, very important. So please keep in the mind, friends. And during, okay, 2021-2022, Geological Survey of India has carried out, okay, you can say 7 projects in lithium, on lithium in Arunachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Jammu and Kashmir, and Rajasthan. But friends, also we can say, however, the resource of lithium has not been, okay, augmented by Geological Survey of India. But researcher at the Atomic Mineral, okay, Directorate for Exploration and Research, which is a constituent of Department Atomic Energy, has estimated lithium reserve of 14,100 tons in a small patch of land survey in Southern Karnataka, Mandya district. Please keep in the mind, so, okay, Southern Karnataka, Mandya district. And this is very, very important, okay? And friends, you'll have to keep in the mind, what is Atomic Minerals Directorate, okay? AMD. Now I'm going to tell you one line or two lines, okay? So basically, Atomic Minerals Directorate has the mandate of surveying, prospecting, and developing of resources of uranium, thorium, niobium, tantalum, lithium, beryllium, and rare earth element. Okay, as these minerals are required for supporting the nuclear power program of India. Okay, so I told you about the Atomic Minerals Directorate. And friends, exploratory, okay, work has been done for extracting lithium from brine pools of Rajasthan and Gujarat have been published. And the reports of mica belts of Odisha, okay, please keep in the mind, and Chhattisgarh have also been published, and they are, okay, pegmatite, that means igneous rock belts, and most of the, okay, pegmatites have a composition of quartz, feldspar, and mica. Quartz, okay, feldspar, and mica. So basically, we can say ki in India, Arunachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Jammu Kashmir, Rajasthan, Gujarat, okay, basically, Deccan Plateau. And in the northeast, okay, so please keep in the mind. And also you can say in hilly area, there is a chance, okay, of you can say lithium reserve. You know, so please, there is a possibility of lithium reserve, okay. So please keep in the mind, this is very, very important. Now friends, let's discuss the related to what is the other available option, okay. What is the other available option of, you can say, lithium. So what is the another, okay, available option of lithium. So let's discuss one by one. Okay. So first of all, friends, there is Toyota, okay, solid state battery. Please keep in the mind, Toyota solid state battery. And Toyota is the leader. Okay. It is the company. Okay. And Toyota is the leader when it comes to holding the maximum number of patents involving solid state battery. And if everything goes according to Toyota's plan, it is going to be the first company to sell an electrical vehicle with a solid state battery. Okay. And it is planning to launch a prototype this year, 2021. And the second option is, friend, Apple. Okay. Apple battery tech. And Apple is also company. Okay. And Apple is targeting 2024 to unveil its breakthrough battery technology, which could radically reduce the cost of batteries. And the third available option is quantum escape solid state battery. Quantum, okay, escapes solid state battery, and it is a California based battery startup, and with financial backing from Volkswagen, and they are the leading developers of solid state lithium metal batteries. Okay, do you know, friends, our prime minister visited United States, okay, America, and there were meeting, okay, related to CEO of Qualcomm. So please keep in the mind, okay, this is very, very important. And because we'll get we'll cover a topic related to quad, where but I have covered in various classes topics related to quad, okay. So but in upcoming classes also I will discuss relation between India and America, okay, then also what will be the impact of you can say quad, okay. And now next other available option is when Tesla new tabless battery, and the tab is that part of the battery which makes the connection between the cell and what it is powering. And these cells are also called 4860 cell. Please keep in the mind, I'm trying to write with mouse, but it is not possible. So Tesla new tabless battery, I told you that these cells are also called 4860 cell. And according to Tesla company, it can dramatically reduce the cost of electrical vehicles and bring its pricing at par with the conventionally powered ones. Okay, so we have discussed various points related to, you can say, lithium, then option available for lithium. So what should be the conclusion points? According to me, friends, climate has caused the world to bend its knee. And in the pursuit of moving towards an environmentally friendly lifestyle, electrical vehicles are being projected as a potential solution. And India is home, okay? India is home to some of the most polluted city in the world, and may not be in position to rapidly transform its fuel-based vehicles to electrical vehicles. So we have to depend on external supplies for lithium metal, and this makes us vulnerable to imports. And we have, that means the India have set 350 gigawatt by 2030 as our renewable energy goal. And friends, Indian government is also taking steps like a production linked incentive scheme for manufacturing advanced chemistry cell batteries goes a long way. And friends, however, India does not have enough reserve of lithium to achieve its target. So we have to speed up its discovery and exploitation in India and abroad. For example, initiative like Kabil. I told you now, Kabil. What is the meaning of Kabil? Khanij Videsh India Limited. Okay. And why? To make India self-reliant in the renewable energy sector. Okay. So we have discussed related to lithium and its distribution across the globe. Do you have any doubt, okay, in this topic? If you have, feel free to ask, okay, or is it clear? If it is clear, I will move on. Anyone? Do you know, friends, this topic is very, very important, okay? You can get question related to renewable energy, you can get question related to environment, okay, you can get question related to pollution. So basically, you will have to keep in the mind these facts. You will have to keep in the mind these, okay, you can say key concept. So you can write your answer, you can say, in a structured way. And after that, please try to write your answer. And also, okay, if you write your answer in, you can say, in proper structure, you'll get one or two extra marks, okay? And if you'll get one or two extra marks in 10 questions, that means you'll get extra 10 marks. And extra 10 marks, okay, will decide your rank. So please keep in the mind, according to me, we should, okay, ek bahut acha hindi mein kahavat hai ki sabhi to padhte hai pass hone ke liye, lekin mere liye, agar aap log hindi samajhte ho to main aapko ek line mein bolta hu, okay, ki agar aap padhte ho to ye socho ki mujhe kisi se behtar karna hai aur mujhe kisi se behtar rank lana hai. क्योंकि फेल कोई नहीं होता सिविल सर्विस में, ओके, इन सिविल सर्विस नो विन फेल, ओके, नो वन विल फेल. सो प्लीज कीप इन द माइंड, ट्राई टू, ओके, डू हार्ड वर्क, try to write your answer, try to cover each and every point, try to cover whole syllabus. And after that, if you face any problem, I will available for you. You can, okay, send me a mail, and also you can contact with our team, okay. And after that, if you need, okay, you can say keep personal mentoring, I will be available. So please keep in the mind, and okay, and please try to participate in my class. Okay, if you not participate, that means ki I am here only for story. I will tell you a story, you will listen. Okay, but this is not good according to me. So please, please keep in the mind. Please try to participate. Okay, and please keep in the mind, no one is perfect. Our friends, you are okay. Everyone is mature. Okay, so please keep in the mind. And if you'll participate, okay, for example, if you can, you can say, okay, tell me one extra points. This will be okay. You can say very, very good. Not only for you, for everyone. So please keep in the mind. Okay, and also you can send me the message. Okay, yes sir, clear. Move ahead. Also, you do not want to write proper. So well, okay, you can say you do not write to one proper sentence. You can all, you can only send me yes. Why? Yeah, why? Why means yes sir and no. No problem. Okay, if you have doubt, you can raise your hand. Okay, yes sir, I have doubt. I will listen to your doubt, and after that I will try to destroy your doubt. Anyone, is it clear?
Clear sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, very good.
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you. So now let's move ahead, and now we are going to cover a topic related to international, okay, current affairs. Friends, again, I'm sorry. Okay, my pen tab is not working, so I am not able to write anything. Okay, but in our next class, I will use my pen tab. Okay, I will purchase a new one, and after that, I will use. So please try to cooperate. And so now let's discuss the topics related to international relation. And the topic is AUKUS Security Alliance. AUKUS Security Alliance. Okay, and this topic is related to international relation. So what is the context, friend? Recently, the America, okay, the United Kingdom and Australia announced a new trilateral security partnership, AUKUS, that means AUKUS, okay, Australia, United Kingdom and United States. ASA Australia, okay, please keep in the mind, and UKSA, United Kingdom, USA, United States. So AUKUS Security Alliance. So recently, the America, the United Kingdom and Australia announced a new trilateral security partnership. Okay, please keep in the mind. So what is AUKUS pact? Let's discuss. Friends, the historic, okay, grouping will advance strategic interest and uphold the international rules-based order along with generating hundreds of high-skilled jobs. And under the first major initiative of AUKUS, Australia would build a fleet of nuclear-powered submarines with the help of America and United Kingdom. And friends, a capability aimed at promoting stability in Indo-Pacific region. So basically, AUKUS backed, okay, wants to increase the dominance in Indo-Pacific region. Okay, and also you can say the AUKUS, okay, group wants stability in Indo-Pacific region. Indo-Pacific region. So what is the highlights of AUKUS alliance? Okay, let's discuss the highlights. What is the highlights of AUKUS alliance? So first of all, friends, in a highlights, there is, okay, India-Pacific focus. What India, also you can say Indo-Pacific focus. So the Australia, United Kingdom, United States Pact security team will focus on developing strategic interest in the Indo-Pacific region. And although the US, okay, has openly denied that the collection is targeted at China, and its Indo-Pacific status make it an ally against China independent action in South China Sea. And we have discussed in previous classes, okay, related to South China Sea. And friends, these three countries, okay, alongside Canada and New Zealand, already share a deep understanding of Five Eyes partnership. Five Eyes partnership. Okay, in a Five Eyes partnership, you will have to keep in the mind Canada, New Zealand, okay, Australia, United Kingdom, and USA. Okay, And the next point is related to, okay, most important point is transferring okay nuclear vessels to Australia. And as part of this AUKUS program, Australia will acquire submarines with assistance from the United Kingdom and United States. And friends, the move is significant because the America has only shared marine chemical technology before, and it began in 1958 with Great Britain. And now America will share, you can say, technology related to marine, okay, with Australia. And first of all, America share technology related to marine with Great Britain in 1958. And friends, nuclear power submarine are quicker than their standard counterparts, but also more capable of being installed for longer periods of time and need to appear more frequently. And apart from India's stated goal of acquiring more nuclear power submarine, it will lead to an increase in changes in quartz undersea power and anti-submarine warfare. And I told you in a previous classes we had discussed the quad in quad. Okay, so can you tell me which country is the part of quad?
Australia, India. Japan,
Australia.
Australia,
Australia, India, Japan, and US.
Yeah, Deji.
Say US, India, Japan, and Australia.
Okay, very good. So friends, please keep in the mind what Quad is a collection of India, America, Australia, and Japan. Recently there was a meeting of Quad leader in America. Okay, so now also please keep in the mind Australia now has to join the top 6 nation group, India, US, UK, France, Russia, and China, and using nuclear powered submarine. That means in the world these 6 countries, they have nuclear powered submarine. So which country? India, America, United Kingdom, France, Russia, China, and now Australia. Okay, and it would also be the end of the world to have such submarine without having a nuclear power plant. Okay, after there were also a multi, you can say, letter partnership between Australia, United Kingdom, and America. So AUKUS will also include new building and integration between the 3 countries, as well as partnership in emerging technology, for example, using artificial intelligence, quantum technology, and underwater capabilities. Do you know, friends, China expressed its concern about the AUKUS security alliance. So why did China express its concern about the AUKUS security alliance? Let's discuss, because we should understand why or what is the point of China related to AUKUS security alliance. So can you guess why China expressed its concern about the AUKUS security alliance? Because friends, everyone is mature, and according to me, everyone is preparing for civil service, not only for UPSC and also for state services. So please try to guess why China expressed its concern related to Australia, United Kingdom, United States security alliance. Can you guess? Otherwise I will tell you. Yes, Shobhan.
Sir, basically China want to control South China Sea, so that
yeah, got your point.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, raise your hand. Yeah, Deji.
Sir, because the AUKUS is focused on Indo-Pacific Ocean.
Yeah, very good. Okay, yeah, general knowledge. RK.
वही इंडो पैसिफिक डोमिनेशन से आता है ऐसा ही ना इसलिए वही
ओके एनीवन एल्स एनी न्यू पॉइंट आई वांट न्यू पॉइंट ओके नो वन
सर कैन यू प्लीज से द क्वेश्चन अगेन
ओके सो व्हाई Why did China express its concern about the AU-KUS security alliance? That means, why did China express its concern about the Australia, United Kingdom, United States security alliance? Tejasmita?
Sir, I think maybe China is thinking there is a threat to like against China, and it may be a threat towards that OBOR.
Okay. Ajit? Okay, no problem. I'm going to tell you, okay, please keep in the mind, why did China express its concern about this security alliance? So friends, China is delayed more by AUKUS than Quad, okay? And other Indo-Pacific arrangement for the following region, please keep in the mind. First, AUKUS aim to protect the strategic interest of the partner in the region across the 2C and 30 country, okay, 38 country. 2C and 38 countries, okay? And second, it is a message to China that America will one day do the same to other country in the region. For example, sharing, okay, military and critical skills such as cyber, artificial intelligence, and computing. And it is a cause for concern in China, as these are the key area in which China currently governs. Okay, also we can say ki these are the key area in which China currently dominate the world. And third point is, friend, AUKUS is a security group, and like Quad, which is a communication group. So China, okay, is more, you can say ki also you can say ki China knows that AUKUS more challengeable than Quad. Okay, basically AUKUS is a security group and Quad is a communication group. And the fourth reason is, friend, the declaration marks a new decline in Australia-China relation. In previous classes, I have discussed, okay, related to Australia-China relation, and because I have covered the Quad, okay, so please keep in the mind that the declaration marks a new decline in Australia-China relation, because presently Australia-China relation is, you can say, not in a good way, okay, also is not in, you can say, friendly relation. Okay, there is tussle between Australia and China. And China is Australia's largest trading partner with about $200 billion. Trading in two ways. But the relationship has been strained over the past few years. Okay. So for these regions alone, China called the new Australia, okay, United Kingdom, United States alliance extremely damaging to the peace and stability of the Indo-Pacific region. Okay, Indo-Pacific region. So, good evening, Anita ji. Yeah. So, I told you why China, okay, expressed its concern about this security alliance. So, now, friends, what does the AUKUS security alliance mean in India? That means, what is the importance of AUKUS security alliance for India? So, according to Indian observers, the partnership is very beneficial to India. Okay, the partnership is very beneficial to India. And as India has been at the forefront of uniting the unity of the Indo-Pacific countries. So what will be the benefits? Can you tell me? Can you guess? Do you know, friends, why I am asking you? Because I want that if please, okay, if everyone, everyone will participate, okay, and if you can say, will give me only 1 or 2 points, we'll get 10 to 15 points. Because please keep in the mind, okay, in 10 or 15 points, okay, you can say ki all points will be not right. But you can say ki more than 5 to 6 points will be right, and this will be beneficial for everyone. Okay, please keep in the mind. So please try to participate. Don't hesitate, because if you are preparing for UPSC civil service, okay, so you should know how to deliver. You should know how to deliver. You should know how to take action. You should know how to tackle the situation. For example, I'm asking a question, okay, and if you are not replying, that means you do not want okay, to come in the mode of civil service preparation. If you are preparing for civil service, okay, so every time you have the courage to speak, you have to give the reply, okay, and every time, please, please keep in the mind. Yes, Shravan, go ahead.
Sir, basically, Australia is going to deal with France, and the last moment he give up the deal and go with US and UK. So France is basically going to deal with India. Sorry, sir.
Okay, got it. I got your point. Okay, no.
Hello, sir.
Just minute. General knowledge. Yeah, Deji.
Sir, because maybe India is expecting that in future also, like US is transferring nuclear vessels to Australia. Mm-hmm. India is also expecting to get that type of nuclear vessels from US.
And also defense team. Yeah, very good.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, general knowledge. What is your real name?
Sir, Rajesh Kakoti.
Okay.
Yeah,
Rajesh.
USA and Australia is also a member of Kuwait. India is also a member. India is a member of Kuwait. It would be helpful for India because they both. sir.
Yeah, got your point. No problem.
Strategic, Australia and USA. Strategically, if they connected, then India.
Okay. Yeah, got your point. It is here very helpful for strategic point. Sorry, it is most important for India. Okay, in the context of strategic point also. Yeah, anyone else? Vishnu Priya, Tejas Mitra, Ajit Nayak, Anita, okay, then Banita, then there's Meena, yeah, Meena, Pooja, Pratima, Nilen, oh, please try to participate. Subhransu, after a long time, where are you? What are you doing? Please tell me now.
Sir, I was in village, so I could not join last
time. Okay, no problem. Yes. Oh, please go through recorded video. I have covered. You can say lots of important topics for mains and also for prelims. Okay. Yeah, yes, tell sir. Me, what is the importance of AUKAU as security alliance for India?
Sir, both the countries are strategic partner of has been strategic partners from years. So our means their presence also matters for us.
Very good. Okay.
And also about in. There are a lot of things that are happening in South China Sea.
So
to counter all those things, we need partners.
Very good. Okay. So now I'm going to tell you what does the AUKUS Security Alliance mean in India. So first of all, I told you according to Indian Observer, the partnership is very beneficial to India. What will be the benefits? Let's discuss. So first of all, develop Indian partners in Indo-Pacific region and also you can say in the region. So quad, okay, means nothing but the skills development required by all its member, especially Australia and Japan. And this will give, okay, Indian partners more confidence and confidence in their defensive skill. And friends, Australia, okay, United Kingdom, United America, and the future US military base on Australian soil will support India's effort to protect the Indo-Pacific region. Then it will provide much needed time in India to build naval capabilities. Okay, Deji told me, okay, related to you can say a defense deal. So basically we can say in addition AUKUS will buy some valuable time for India to strengthen its rural military capabilities. And then last, India, okay, develops India's ambition for international relation. And partnership, okay, will allow India to demand more of its foreign policy and defense strategy. Okay, so we have discussed about the AUKUS security alliance. So what should be the conclusion? So according to me, India now has very little to worry about before maritime and AUKUS, okay, in the game. And this new alliance could allow the three countries to strengthen their focus on the more difficult part of the world. And the triangular side of AUKUS will be a major message to China, and it will come close to balancing China in the Indo-Pacific region. China in the Indo-Pacific region. Okay. So friends, we have discussed this topic. Okay. Is it clear? Do you have any doubt?
Clear, sir.
Clear, sir.
Okay. So now I'm going to cover a new topic, and the new topic is related to, you can say, the environment. Okay. So, yeah. So new topic is related to environment, and the topic is, friend, you can see here, the Mura Drava Danube, that means MDD, Biosphere Reserve. Okay. This Biosphere Reserve in news. So I thought we should cover this topic because you can say, in the environment portion, there is a chance, okay, related question with biosphere, national park, wildlife sanctuary. So this is very, very important. So friend, what is the context? Okay, recently the UNESCO, okay, so please keep in the mind, recently the UNESCO designated Mura Drava, okay, Danube as the world's first 5-country biosphere reserve. Please keep in the mind, what? World's first 5-country biosphere reserve. So what is Mura Drava Danube, MDD? So friend, this area crossing the biosphere boundaries run along the Drava, Mura and Danube rivers, and that are separated by flood-proof dikes in the floodplain and floodplain. Okay. And you can say that nature reserves provide an important tool for learning the various methods of flood management. And the park covers 700 kilometers of Mura, Drava and Danube rivers and extends to Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Hungary and Serbia. Please keep in mind what? Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Hungary and Serbia. And friends, the complete park area in the Amazon of Europe make it one of the most protected river area on the continent. So please keep in the mind. So basically we can say ki Mura Drava Danube is the river, and please keep in the mind. And also you can say ki the park covers 700 kilometers of the Mura Drava and Danube rivers, and it extends to Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Hungary and Serbia. And friends, what is the importance of this, you can say ki Mura Drava Danube, and also we can say what is the importance of biosphere. So let's see the significance of the biosphere. First of all friends, what is the significance? Different types of earth. So basically the park is home to floodplains, gravel and sandy beaches, river islands, auction and meadows. Please keep in the mind. And then second significance is related to flowers and animals. Second significance is related to flower and animal. So Mura Drava, Drava Danube biosphere is the home to the highest European continent of white breeding eagles with a white tail, that means more than 150 pairs. Then many endangered species such as the small tern, black stork, otter, also there is sturgeon are also found in Mura Danube, Drava Danube biosphere. And it is also an important resting place for the annual migration of more than 250,000 migratory birds according to World Wide Fund. And friends, also we can say more than 9 lakh people live in the biosphere reserve. More than, you can say 9 lakh people live in the biosphere reserve. So these are the most important significance of this biosphere. So what will be the, you can say, benefits of UNESCO decision? So I told you that UNESCO designated Mura Drava Danube as the world's first 5-country biosphere reserve. So what will be the benefits? So first of all friends, let's discuss the benefits. Adoption in sustainable environmental efforts. So this new park represents an important contribution to the European Green Deal. and it also has an impact on the implementation of European Union biodiversity strategy in Mura-Drava Danube region. And friends, this also you can say key purpose of also we can say key the purpose of Jesus, okay, will you can say key enhance and will achieve. And then also we can see there will be a rehabilitation of 2,500, okay, sorry, 25,000, okay, miles of river once, and protecting 30% of the European Union, okay, by you can say 2030. And then push to promote sustainable business action. These are the hope, okay, you can say the purpose of this, and also you can say ki these are the purpose of European Union. And the adoption of, okay, Mura, you can say ki Mura-Drava Danube, okay, was the mandate of all five countries to jointly promote the protection and rehabilitation of the Mura-Drava Danube area. Okay, then there will be cooperation, okay, of the natural cross. So please keep in the mind cooperation of the natural cross. Okay, and friends, the Inter-Danube transnational program funded by the Amazon of Europe bike trail project is an example of international efforts to promote environmentally friendly practices. And the project is a long distance cycling, okay, route that covers the whole area of Mura-Drava and Danube river across 1,250 kilometers. And friends, when you book this cycling trip, a portion of the money is spent directly on the region's, okay, conservation program. So friends, now let's discuss the most important facts I'm going to tell you about the biosphere reserve in India, because biosphere is in news. Okay, yeah, Deji.
So what is mean by the last point?
Cooperation, okay, of the natural cross.
Yes, sir.
Okay. For example, you can say ki Mura, okay, Mura and Danube is the part of five countries. Okay. And for example, if anyone you can say ki will book a tour, okay, for the you can say Mura, Mura and Danube, you can say ki biosphere reserve. So money will be spent on this region. And for example, if there is five country, okay, and that means ki there will be border between these five countries, okay, and that means ki there will be cooperation between these five country, cooperation for conservation, cooperation for promoting, cooperation for tourism, cooperation for hospitality, okay, there will be cooperation between five country.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah, now I told you, please keep in the mind Mura-Drava Danube, okay, biosphere reserve in a one line, single line. It is related to, okay, first five country biosphere reserve, and who designated? So UNESCO designated. And you can, you'll have to keep in the mind only two points. So first of all, UNESCO designated Mura-Drava Danube as the world's first five country biosphere reserve. And second point, you'll have to keep in the mind Austria, Slovenia, Croatia, Hungary and Serbia, okay, these you can say are the country which have rights on Mura-Drava Danube biosphere reserve. So five countries, please keep in the mind. So now I am going to tell you the extra information related to biosphere topic. Why? Because biosphere is in frequent use, so maybe UPSC can ask a question related to biosphere reserve in India. So now I'm going to tell you. So can you tell me presently how many biosphere reserve in India? Anyone?
Sorry, this 36.
36? UNESCO?
18, sir.
Yeah.
18.
Yeah, very good. 18. So presently there are 18 biosphere reserve in India. Okay. And among which 12 biosphere reserve in India find their place in UNESCO list of man and biosphere reserve program. Okay, please keep in the mind. Current affairs means not only you can say current affair portion. Current affairs means if you, okay, are reading a topic related to current affairs, so you should read, or you should okay, also cover the topics related to static portion. So we have discussed a topic related to current affairs. So that means we should also know about the, okay, static portion of this topic. And also we can say whenever we'll cover any topics related to world, so please try to cover what is the facts related to this topic, okay, in India. So please keep in the mind. So presently there are 18 biosphere reserve in India, and among which 12 biosphere reserve in India find their place in UNESCO list of man and biosphere reserve program. Okay, friends, I will not go with the 12th name. So okay, 12 list of, you can say, man and biosphere reserve. So it is your duty. In our next class, I will ask you, okay, the name of 12 biosphere reserve, which is the parts of UNESCO list of man and biosphere reserve. So please keep in the mind. And friends, the latest, okay, included under the man, also you can say okay, man and biosphere reserve program, okay, biosphere reserve is Panna biosphere reserve. Panna biosphere reserve in Madhya Pradesh. You know, na, ki Panna is also famous for diamond. Okay, please keep in the mind. There is Panna mines. And friends, in India also you can say ki there are 727 biosphere reserve, okay, in 131 country. Please keep in the mind. You can say ki in 131 country in the world, there are 727 biosphere reserve, including 22 is transboundary sites. Transboundary site means between two or three country, more than two country. Okay. And friends, in biosphere reserve, okay, they you can say in biosphere reserve, you'll get a three main zone. Okay. Please keep in the mind, I do not have pen tab. Okay. So, but I'm going to tell you ki in biosphere reserve, you'll get three main zone. So first, core area, please keep in the mind. For example, okay, this is the biosphere reserve. So first of all, you'll get a core area. Okay. Then you'll get a buffer zone. Okay. You'll get a buffer zone. Okay. And after that, you'll get a transition zone. Transition zone. So what is the means of core area? Core area means, also you can say ki core area comprises a strictly protected zone that contributes to the conservation of landscape, ecosystem, species and genetic variation. Okay, so core area comprises strictly protected zone, that means no human activity. Okay, now let's discuss buffer zone. So buffer zone, okay, surrounds or adjoins the core area and is used for activities compatible with sound ecological practice and that can reinforce scientific research and monitoring, training and education. So in buffer zone, there will be activity, but only for, you can say, ecological practice and only for scientific research. Okay. Then third is transition area. And the transition area is where communities foster socio-culturally and ecologically sustainable economic and human activities. So basically in transition area, there will be, you can say, the agriculture also, there will be the wood collecting. Okay. Then also the tribal rights. So please keep in the mind. So I told you three area, core area, no human activity, buffer zone, yes, activity, but only for study purpose. Then transition area, okay, area, yeah, there will be activity, you can say, for foster socio-culturally and ecologically sustainable economic and human activities. Okay, so we have discussed the topics related to Mura, Drava, Danube, biosphere reserve. Do you have any doubt? Anyone?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So now let's discuss a topic related to bad bank. Okay. This is very, very important for mains. Okay. Please keep in the mind. And the topic is related to economy portion. So bad bank will help to clean up the balance sheet. Okay. Bad bank, please keep in the mind, will help to clean up the balance sheet. So first of all, friends, what is the context? Let's discuss. Okay, and please give me 5 minutes break and please wait. Okay, don't go. I will join within 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, now I'm going to 40. Sorry, so please wait 5 minutes, only 5 minutes.
गुड इवनिंग अनिता मैडम।
या नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड. तो चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं. नाउ द टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू इकोनॉमी, आई टोल्ड यू, एंड द टॉपिक इज बैड बैंक विल हेल्प टू क्लीन अप द बैलेंस शीट एंड व्हाट इज द कॉन्टेक्स्ट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फ्रेंड्स, इन अ रिसेंट डेवलपमेंट, यूनियन फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर निर्मला सीतारमन हैज मेड एन अनाउंसमेंट दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज एक्सटेंडिंग अ गारंटी ऑफ आरएस 30,600 करोड़ टू द National Asset Reconstruction Company (NARCL). Why? To help clear stress loan. Okay. So what is the background? And friends, this announcement is in line with the in budget 2021-2022 when the finance minister had announced for setting up a bad bank to resolve the bad loans. Bad loan means NPA. We'll discuss. Okay. And friends, NARCL, that means the National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, has been incorporated under the Companies Act, which will be tasked to acquire stressed asset worth Rs 2 lakh crore from various commercial banks. And friends, then another entity, India Debt Regulation Company Limited, that means the IDRCL, will try to sell the stressed asset in the market, and jointly National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited and India Debt Regulation Company Limited forms the new bad bank. So please keep in the mind. Okay. So you should have a question, sir. What is the meaning of bad bank?
Sir, can you repeat again, sir? Please, sir.
Yes, of course. So we have discussed that in a budget 2021, there were announcement related to bad bank. That means Indian government will set up a bad bank to resolve the loans. And National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited has been incorporated under the Companies Act, and which will be tasked to acquire a stress asset worth Rs 2 lakh from various commercial banks. Because at present in India, there is 12 nationalized banks. So you'll have to keep in the mind. And the other entity, India Debt Regulation Company Limited, will try to sell the stress asset in the market. And jointly, that means the NARCL, National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited, and IDRCL, that means India Debt Regulation Company Limited, forms the new bad bank. So I told you you should have a question related to bad bank, sir. What is the meaning of bad bank? Okay. But presently, I have a question. Can you tell me what is the meaning of bad bank? What is bad bank? Is there anything concept related to good bank or bad bank? Or what is the meaning of bad bank?
It helps to commercial bank for NPA. Okay. For balance clearance NPA.
Okay, no problem. Yeah, anyone else?
Sir, bad banks are for the recovery of the NPAs. So the banks are given to the commercial sector or any other.
Okay, why there is name bad bank?
It's manage bad assets.
Yeah, Daddy.
So it helps those banks which are in maybe in loss. Okay. That is why it is known as bad bank.
Yeah, Nihar.
Yes, sir. So actually, the bad bank concept has first created by US. In US, a bank was started in 1988. Which has implemented this type of concept, and later on, when it became successful, other countries like Sweden, Finland, France, and Germany, they also followed that concept. So this is about the bad bank concept. Is this bank is dealing with bad loans? For that reason, it is bad bank. It will take over the bad loans or the NPA from the commercial banks. It will manage them. And finally, recovers the money. Okay, it will recover the money. Yeah.
Yeah. Very good.
So, yeah.
Yes. So now I'm going to tell you what is the meaning of you can say bad bank. Okay. So we can see here bad bank, okay, it's a corporate structure that takes charge, okay, of the toxic asset. Toxic asset means there is, okay, two words. Please keep in the mind, asset and, okay, non-performing asset. That means ke NPA. Please keep in the mind. NPA means if there is a loan, okay, but bank is not receiving any, you can say, interest rate or any principal amount, okay, within 90 days. After that, this, you can say, loan account will be considered in NPA. But there are two types of NPA. You'll have to keep in the mind, NPA for agriculture, NPA for industrial sector, okay, and also for the commercial sector. And also in agriculture sector, there is two types of NPA, okay. Basically, in agriculture, there is a short-term loan and there is a long-duration loan. Okay, that means the loan for short, okay, duration crops and, okay, loans for long duration crops. For short, okay, duration crop, there will be two, you can say, ki, you can say, ki, two, that means ki 6 months, 6 months. Okay, that means they will get, you can say, ki 1 year. But for a long duration group, only 1 year. For example, sugarcane, okay, so please keep in the mind. But in industry, okay, there is, you can say, ki only 90 days. Okay, if you, for example, okay, if you have education loan and if you do not, you can say, ki, you can say, ki, okay, you can say, na, ki, if you do not deposit interest or principal amount after 90 days, bank will consider this loan, education loan, in NPA, okay, non-performing asset. In asset, there is also various types of asset. I will not go in a detail, okay, but you'll have to keep in the mind what is the meaning of NPA. NPA means non-performing asset. Non-performing means there is no interest rate, okay, that means bank is not receiving interest rate or no, okay, you can say, no principal amount, okay, please keep in the mind. So what is bad bank? I told you it is a corporate structure, okay, and that takes charge of the toxic asset, that means non-performing asset held by banks in a separate entity, okay. And bad bank is established by non-performing asset from a bank and later selling them in the market. Please, for example, okay, first of all, there is SBI, okay, SBI is the largest bank of India, and SBI has, you can say, 1 lakh crore NPA. So first of all, bad bank will purchase NPA from, you can say, SBI. And SBI, okay, you can say, okay, why SBI will sell NPA? Because SBI wants their money, okay. For example, bad bank will purchase, okay, and after that, bad bank, okay, will contract with SBI. Okay. For example, if there is 100 rupees and bad, okay, bad bank, for example, okay, bad bank will sell this 100 rupees in market. So after that, bad bank will say to SBI, I will pay you only 80 rupees, okay. And 20 rupees is mine. That means for commission. Okay. Because I have recovered this amount. Okay. So please keep in the mind. So bad bank established by non-performing asset from a bank and later selling them in the market. And friends, bad bank relieves the commercial banks from getting rid of their stress asset and enables them to focus on resuming their normal banking operation. Resuming their normal banking operation. Okay. So this is all about bad banks. So that means ki, you can say na ki who, please keep in the, yeah, Nihar. Nihar told us that means ki, why there is bad bank. Bad bank means bad bank. Also you can say a commercial setup. Okay. If purchase NPA, NPA means bad, you can say ki loans. Bad loans means ki bank is not getting interest rate or not, you can say deposit amount, principal amount. Okay. So first of all, if any bank will purchase NPA and it will sell in the market, it will be known as bad bank. Bad bank means bad, you can say, ki loans. That means if any institute, okay, will recover, you can say, ki loan amounts by selling NPA, that will be known as bad banks. So bad banks, I told you, it is a structure that takes the charge of the non-performing asset and which is, okay, that is held by banks. Okay, in a separate entity. Okay, so I told you about the bad bank. So friends, we should understand why there is a need for a bank. Okay, bad bank. Why there is a need for a bad bank? Let's understand one by one. Why? Okay, so first of all, friends, To put it simply, commercial bank accept deposit and provides loans to there. Okay, so do you know there is two things? One thing is bank, okay, and the second thing is NBFC, non-banking financial company. So what is the difference between bank and NBFC? Can you tell me, anyone? I'm not testing your knowledge. I want only participation from your side. I'm not here for judge your knowledge, okay? Judging your knowledge. I'm here only for your, you can say, okay, for your future. That means I can give you more points. If you'll participate, you'll get more points. So please keep in the mind. Yeah, anyone can tell me? Yeah, Shobhan.
Sir, banks follow rules and regulation created by RBI, and NBFC does not bound to follow RBI.
No. NBFC also follow RBI rule and regulation.
Okay, sir.
Yes, anyone else? Nihar? Hey, ji, Anita?
Sir.
Yeah, Nihar.
Sir, NBFC is, and banks is a common difference, sir. The difference is banks operate through banking license and NBFCs are not having that license. And second one is NBFCs are not allowed to take deposits.
Yes, very good. Yeah. It is the main difference. I want to know this. First of all, banks, okay, which institute or you can say company who accept deposit and provides loans. Okay, there is a definition, section 5.1. I will not go in this, you can say definition, but you'll have to keep in the mind. If any institute who provides, okay, loans, that means who provides credit and accepts deposit, that will be known as banks. But NBFC, non-banking financial company, only provides loans, that means credit, and not accept the deposit. Okay, please keep in the mind, this is the main difference. Okay, so now let's discuss why there is a need for bad bank. So I told
sir, you, NBFC RD or sir FD करता है sir NBFC
क्या करता है
RD sir okay. RD और FD yes sir
हाँ so हो सकता है वो उसके बारे में अभी मुझे knowledge नहीं है हो सकता है कि शायद वो current account से related कुछ नहीं करता और लेकिन लगता नहीं है क्योंकि NBFC का clear definition है कि only it provides loans credit so I will check okay
Yes, sir.
After that, I will tell you in the next class. So, yeah.
Yes, sir.
So, to put it simply, commercial bank accept deposit and provides loans to their customer. And the deposit are considered a liability. Okay. Liability for bank and asset for consumers. Okay. Liability because the bank is supposed to return the money to the depositor and also pay the interest on those deposits. And on the contrary, friends, the loans that banks give is considered as their asset. That means if you will take a loan from banks, it is liability for you and asset for bank. Okay, so I told you if a loan that bank give is considered as their asset, because in this case the bank can earn interest and this is the money that borrower will have to return. And this business model is based on idea that earning made by the banks by lending money to the borrowers will be more than what it would have to pay to its depositor. But in scenario where the borrowers fail to repay the principal amount or the interest, this aggravates the risk of a loan converting into NPA, non-performing asset. And friends, the overwhelming chunk of the NPA is lying mostly with the public sector bank. Public sector bank means owned by the government bank and hence by the public. And to keep these banks running, the government is sometimes forced to recapitalize them using the taxpayer money so that the bank can continue with the lending and funding economic activities. And to free the banks from these stress asset or non-performing asset, the need for the creation of bad banks aroused. And entity where the stress asset can be parked. Okay, and now the commercial bank can resume their usual business operation, especially lending, and the bad bank could try to sell this asset in the market. Okay, so please keep in the mind, this is very, very important. So NPA that banks have, that means the total bad loans in the Indian banking system amount to Rs 8.35 lakh crore in March 2021. Okay, please keep in the mind. And friends, according to the World Bank data, the share of NPA to gross loan in Indian bank is significantly higher, okay, compared to developed Western economies. So you can see here, this is the existing level
sir,
of...
Sir, I have a question, sir. Is there any relationship with the bad bank and the NBFC? Or...
Yes, sir. You can say that bad bank is, okay, you can say related to NPA because it's a, if bad bank will set up, so main purpose, okay, will be bad bank set up. That means they, first of all, purchase their stress, okay, or NPA from bank, commercial bank. And after okay. that, they will sell it in the market. Okay, that means market. They want to, okay, recover the loans or money. Okay, yeah, this is a direct relationship between bad banks and also you can say NPA. Okay.
Sir, can an NBFC can be a bad bank?
Oh. No. Bad bank is different. For example, bad bank also you can say bad bank also, okay, you can say he can purchase a stress asset from non-banking financial company because non-banking financial company provides loans or credit, okay, and if there is you can say any loan amount which is the part of a stress asset, so NBFC will sell to the bad bank, and after that bad bank, okay, sell in the market and they will recover, okay, and for this you can say sell and purchase, bad bank will get a commission, okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So now let's discuss the existing level of NPA in bank. So these foreign banks, public sector banks, private sector banks, and scheduled commercial bank. So you can see here, okay, in public sector bank, you can see here 9.5%. Okay, that means the total level of NPA in bank 9.54% in public sector bank. Then in private sector bank, only 4.78%. Then foreign bank, 2.43%. And all scheduled commercial bank, 7.48%. Okay. Of the total deposit, please keep in the mind. Now, let's discuss the NPA. And now I'm going to, okay, you can say compare between India and developed country. So you can see here, NPA in 2016 in America 1.3%, United Kingdom 0.9%, Germany 1.7%, China 1.7%, but in India 9.2%, and highest in Russia 9.4% of total loan amount. Okay, now let's come to the, you can say NPA in 2018 in America 0.9%, United Kingdom 11%, Germany 12%, China 1.8%, India 9.5%, and Russia 10.1%. Okay, so that means we can say NPA is increasing in India and also in Russia. Okay, so please keep in the mind. And friends, there's a cash. Okay, also you can say capital adequacy ratio. And now I'm going to tell you, according to Financial Stability Report. Okay, Financial Stability Report issued by RBI, Reserve Bank of India. And also you can say that according to the Financial Stability Report issued by RBI, the CRR, okay, of scheduled commercial bank increased from 14.7% in March 2020 to 16% in March 2021. 16% in March 2021. So please keep in the mind. This is very, very important. Okay. So now we can say the CRAR means capital adequacy ratio, okay, also known as capital to risk weighted asset ratio. It is a part of banking terminology. Okay, I will not go in this detail, but you'll have to keep in the mind the capital adequacy, okay, what capital adequacy ratio measures a bank's financial stability by measuring its available capital as a percentage of its weighted credit risk exposure. And the Basel III norms stipulated a capital to risk, okay, with asset of 8% and a higher, okay, capital adequacy rate so that the bank is better capitalized to handle NPAs. That means, for example, according to Basel III norms, okay, if banks provides 100 rupees, so banks should maintain 8%. That means the 8 rupees for their, you can say, ke emergency situation. For their emergency situation, please keep in the mind. Okay. And if bank has a higher capital adequacy rate, that means ki bank is better capitalized to handle non-performing asset. Okay. Now, let's discuss the details related to, you can say...
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, you're talking about Basel III norm, yeah. But Basel III norm India has not accepted till now. Even it has not accepted Basel II also. But how it will correlate with that?
Yeah. No, no. Because Basel III norms is related to international banking. Okay. And if you are talking about international banking, that means ki Indian banking is also part of the international banking. We cannot ignore it. Okay. Yeah, India is not following Basel norms 2 or 3. Okay. But for example, if banks provides loans, okay, so banks consider their, you can say, ki their future. That means ki in future, if bank will, okay, not, okay, you can say, ki get their amounts. For this, you can say, ki situation, bank, okay, should. That means reserve, and also you can say if bank provides 100 rupees, so that means ki 8% should be in the, you can say, ki reserve for the future. That means ki for the emergency situation. It is not compulsory. I told you, it is not compulsory, but bank should maintain 8% reserve. Okay, it is not compulsory. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is not compulsory. Because India is not following, and also you can say ki Basel norms 3. So it is not possible, but India is a part of the, you can say now, Indian banking is a part of the global banking. SBI is the top, you can say ki 55 or 50. SBI is ranked in the whole, you can say ki world, 55 or 50. I'm not getting exactly. So, but you'll have to keep in the mind, if SBI provides 1,000 rupees, so you can say the 80 rupees for, you can say, the emergency situation. Emergency situation means ki if bank will not get their money from borrowers. Okay, so please keep in the mind, if bank reserves more CR, you can say capital adequacy ratio, so it show that means the bank is in better situation to handle NPA, to better in a better situation for handle emergency crisis. Okay. So in 2008 or 2008 to 2011, there were problems in the American banking system. That means the American banking system did not follow this capital adequacy ratio. So in 2008 to 2011, there were various banks which have shut down in American economy. So please keep in the mind. But now Indian banking is also, you can say, follow 6 to 8% reserve, and also there's a news related to private sector bank, and private sector bank, they follow 10% reserve. Okay, so please keep in the mind. Yeah, so now I told you the related to this. Okay, so we have discussed these things. Okay, now I'm going to tell you about the National Asset Reconstruction Company Limited and India Debt Resolution Company Limited functioning. Okay, what is the functioning or working of NARCL and ID RCL. Okay, so let's discuss. First of all, friends, the transfer of bad loans will be done in phased manner. Okay, and under this framework, the NARCL has proposed to acquire a stress asset of about ₹2 lakh crore. Okay, ₹2 lakh crore. So please keep in the mind, ₹2 lakh crore, and about 90,000 crore worth of bad loans has been planned to transfer in the first phase. Okay, in first phase. And at the first, the NARCL will purchase bad loans from banks, and it will pay 15% of the agreed price in cash. Please keep in the mind, 15% of the agreed price in cash, and remaining 85% will be in the form of security receipt. Okay, security receipt. And when the asset...
Sir, what do you mean by security receipt?
For example, you have bank accounts. Whenever you have, you deposit in your bank, you will get a receipt. Okay, so also you can say this is a security receipt. Security receipt means ki bank, will get money, but in, you can say ki fixed time, in a fixed interest rate. Okay, so this is, you can say, these are the examples of security receipt. Okay, no need to go in detail because the UPSC or state service not will not ask a question basically related to security receipt, but you'll have to keep in the mind security receipt means, that means, for example, Nihar promised to me I will pay you 100 rupees, and I will pay you 100 rupee in a 1 year, so they will give me a certificate that I will pay you in a 100 rupee at the date of this, and I will get this receipt. So that means this is my security receipt. I will get this money, but after a few days or after 1 year or after a fixed time. Okay. So please keep in the mind security receipt. Told you. And also we can say there is a various definition related to security receipt. That means it means a receipt or other security issued by an asset reconstruction company to any qualified buyer pursuant to a scheme and evidencing the purchase or acquisition by the holder thereof and undivided right, title or interest in the financial asset involving securitization. That means basically we can say it is a receipt related to the will get the money within the debt period. Okay. And also there is a, you can say when a bank sell a bad loan to asset reconstruction company, it is 85% payment through security receipt, which is redeemed when the entire recovery is made. Okay, that is on a date. And these security receipts are rated twice every year to determine the recovery potential. Okay. Now, I told you at the first, and they are purchased bad loans sometimes, and it will pay 50% of the agreed price in cash, and the remaining 85% will be in the form of security receipt. Okay. Very important. Now, friends, if the bad banks fail to sell the bad loans or sell it at a loss, and government guarantee will be involved, and the difference in the price that the bank, bad bank will be getting, and what the commercial bank was supposed to pay will be paid from a corpus of 30,600 crore have been issued by the government.
Sir, your voice is not clear, Lord Bull, sir.
Sorry for technical problem. Okay. Yeah. So I told you if the bad bank fails to sell the bad loan or sell it a loss, then the government guarantee will be invoked, and the difference between the price that the bad bank will be getting and what the commercial. ARCL, purchase stress from SBI on 1 lakh rupees, and they sell in the market, but a bad bank only get 90,000. That means bad bank will loss in 10,000. So 10,000 loss will be covered by Indian government, so please keep in the mind. So Indian government or Ministry of Finance announced the 30,600 crore package for bad banks. Okay. So this is very, very important. Okay. Now, what is the concern involved the bad bank? Okay. What is the concern related to bad bank? So let's discuss the concern related to bad bank. And friends, from the perspective of NPA laden bank, that means